At its most basic, literary translation is taking a text and giving it life in another language. This isn't just translating the meaning, but also the tone, the flavour, the things that make it exciting for people to read, the things that make it literature.
I think a lot of people misunderstand translation. So I've had customers, in fact, tell me, well, it's not that difficult to translate. All you have to do is look up some words in the dictionary and write the first thing that shows in the dictionary. And you think, well, no, that's completely wrong. Translation is first and foremost a form of creative writing. There are a lot of skills and talents that you need in order to be a successful translator. One of the most important things is that you have to be somebody who is comfortable with both the source and the target languages. Many people forget the second bit. They think, oh, I'm really good at French and English is my native language, so of course I can translate from French to English, but that's not how it works. You have to be somebody who is a wordsmith in both languages. You have to love language. You have to love writing. You have to love editing. You have to love the whole process there.
For me, translation is, it's an ideal way of combining a love of words with a love of literature in a job which lets me work on my own, which I love for the most part.
I was living in Japan for 2 months doing an internship, and I bought a book by a writer named Kawabata Yasunari, or Yasunari Kawabata in the American or British order, in the English language order. And I was reading it, and there was this one story in particular that I thought was just incredible. It was so incredible that I thought, boy, I wish my friends could read this. I wish my sister could read this. I wish my parents could read this. And since they don't read Japanese, they couldn't. And that's how I decided to translate it. And so I thought, I mean, in a sense, I think a literary translator will frequently be somebody who has a sense that, you know, in this language, there are all these great books, there's all this great stuff that I'd like to be able to share. And taking that sense of, you know, this desire to share wonderful things with other people and transforming it into actual text that can be shared with other people is basically what a literary translator is doing.
There's a reason why I translate. There's a reason why I'm a translator. It's because I'm interested in finding unheard voices. So that's why I have this urge when I hear a voice, and I really use this word hearing, not reading, but hearing, because it's something that even when I read a page, I do hear the words and it touches me. So that's why I use this verb. When I hear new voices, I feel this urge to get them heard outside of their cultural context, outside of the country, whichever country this is. Usually it's Turkey. So this is what motivates me as a translator. And this is the reason why I feel it is important to get off the page, to do things outside of just the act of translation. And this, for instance, I do participating to festivals, using my knowledge of certain literatures, using my knowledge, for instance, of comics at comics festivals, going to schools, and this is also what I'm doing now here with this residency at the Free Word Center. At the Free Word Center, I have the opportunity for a period of 4 months to really tap into my knowledge of Turkish contemporary literature, comics, comics from Algeria, the UK, Turkey, and some other places I like, and use them in order to enter into dialogue with other people, whether it's my fellow translator in residence, Oli, whether it's other translators from the networks we are part of, or with the readers, and more importantly for me, with the schools. Because I really love to work with young people. I really like to share this experience of languages with young people, because there are so many in schools. I know from myself, being from a family coming from Turkey, living in Belgium, growing up in Brussels, then in Amsterdam, now in London, you know, this feeling of being in a place where it's not your native language, how do you deal with these things? And that's why I'm a translator, you know, because I try to find a way to deal with these different languages. And this is something I want to share with the young people. This is something I want to tell them. I want to tell them it's okay to have different cultures, it's okay to speak different languages, and it's okay to mix them. because I'm always very, I don't like it when people say, no, you can't use language in this way. That's not how you speak English. Oh no, in French you can't use this word. Why not? I can do whatever I like. I'm a free person. I have multiple languages. If I want to mix the languages, I do it. As long as people understand me, of course. And this is also something very important to me as a translator. Language is about communication. It's about making yourself understand by other people. And you do that using words, but you can do that using other, you know? You can do that using drawing or sign language. And these are all part of languages. And I think we do, translation is part of our lives, of our everyday lives. Even if we don't, you know, we don't even see it, it is the case. So this is what I like to work and develop with the kids in schools, you know, how can they use these different languages, how can they use these their heritage in order to express, you know, their creativity. And it doesn't have to be about them being, you know, Turkish, or it can be anything else. They can write something about, you know, a science fiction story. They can use their imagination. I really want to use this as a tool to tell them, you can dream, go on, you have the tools, here are your tools. Here's a pen, here's a computer, here are all the languages you can mix. Just dream and create.